Hello and welcome back to the training. So in this video, what I'd like to do is continue our profile optimization. We've covered the name, the category, and the description. More notably, we've gone into how to get the entities, co-occurring key phrases, because that's so powerful for our citations, directories. We use it in our services. We use it inside of so many different aspects of our business. And we know that relevance equals rank. So we want to keep that relevance on everything, right? So what's the most relevant words? That's what we use. In this particular segment, what we're going to do is we're going to go right to the business profile again, right back to the same example. All right. So we'll go into our example here. Inside of this example, we're going to click on edit profile. We did our first sections. So opening date, let's not spoof this. You can spoof this, you can increase, you know, it is quite a CRO optimization trick to say, hey, we've been open 10 years. But again, you're leaving yourself open for competition. You're leaving yourself open for, I don't want to say, but guys like me, right? So, or whomever, competitors, other people want that top position. There's only three spots. If you leave any vulnerability, you know, not saying I would, but there's other SEOs. They're looking for anything to get a position up. All right. So be mindful of this. Plus you have people out there just spam fighting, just looking for anything, just to get another star for their user profile. You know what I'm saying? Be mindful here. So don't do this. Contact information. This is your phone number. All right. If you have more than one phone number, you can add them in, but be mindful though, because your primary number here is what's used on your citations, directories, your PR, everything, right? It should also be on your webpage. So whatever you pick, be mindful of this. But if there are secondary numbers, satellite offices, customer support, whatever it is, you can add an extra number here, all right? Or maybe you're doing a temporary campaign, who knows? You have the ability to do so though, all right? Now, website and URL. A lot of times this is debatable depending on what's going on and how many locations you have, how many services. There's a lot to be done here, all right? But generally speaking, in this particular instance, if we have a business that offers the same service but has more than one Google business profile, if this is you, you have more than one GBP doing the same thing in the same state, right? You want to point the URL for your GBP to the page that's the most relevant to that particular business listing. So for this particular instance, we are a towing service that offers towing services, and this business is verified in Santa Ana. So we're pointing it to our towing services Santa Ana page. All right. Now, again, this is for multi-location, if you have multiple in the same state or very close to each other, let's get those pages optimized. Let's get them tuned and let's have specific numbers, specific location. It's like whole other websites, all right? Internal page. You don't want five locations all pointing to the homepage. That's, you know, you're just fighting yourself, all right? The social profile section, again, if you have more than one location or if you have multiples, they need to be segmented, all right? So if you have more than one location, technically speaking, you should have more than one Google business, more than one business profile on Facebook, more than one business profile on Pinterest. Like, we're creating business profiles. This is link equity. This is co-occurring. There's so many benefits to having more of everything. This is what we want to put. So if you're going to add social profiles, which you should, let's make sure they're specific to the business, the service, and the location. All right. Short name. Obviously, we want to put our name. What's the location? This doesn't really play a part as far as optimization, but you have to fill it out. The location and areas. All right. So your business location was updated by Google. So they must have moved it around. This is my first time getting in here, but I noticed that this particular business has decided to add all of these areas. So here's the formula that I really like to stick with. And this is where we'll end this particular segment, is in the locations. All right. Because all the other ones were just go over, give some tips and move on. But here's what I like to stick with. All right. So when we have a business, all right, especially multi-location, anything, what we have is we have a state, right? So what state are we in? What county? What city or town, right? State, county, city, or town that we're in, all right? By targeting these things, going broad and all the way down, by stuffing these in here, stuffing those locations in, it's not like we're going to fool Google. So we are a business that's in the state of California, in Orange County specifically, and more specifically than that, we are in Santa Ana. Now, I've seen varying results over the course of time, but currently, this is how I would optimize the profile, is we want to go state, county, city, or town that you're in, all right? So let's go ahead and take care of that. California. And that would be my recommendation here. All right, yeah, this is just dilution, you know, like... There's no fooling Google. Plus, on top of that, when you're adding all this extra stuff in here, you're adding zip codes. Cities or towns have more than one zip code, right? So we want to be broad to encompass a specific area. You can't put specifics or... Don't do it. We're going to go California, right? We are a business in California. We are in Orange. Oh, Orange County, California. It's a state. And then on top of that, we are in Santa Ana. Santa Ana. Those are the three right there. Right? They're not in the exact order that I like, but they're there perfectly fine. Google will never give us trouble for having three. Whatever your hours are, let's make sure that that's what we put our hours as. Like, you're open 24 hours? Great. But that would mean that we're also online open 24 hours. So this is always a give that we can always put in here. So whatever your main business hours are, this is your exact online hours. More notably, if you would like, you can also put your online hours to 24/7 because your website never goes down. So for this particular business, though, we are going to put 24. All right. So let's take care of this. And that will be the very last section here. We talked about the social profiles, the descriptions. We talked about which locations to put in. We're ending off with the hours of operation, and that pretty much wraps up this particular segment of optimization. What I want to do here is just take one last little peek here. Anything that's relevant you want to fill out, that is going to wrap it up for this particular optimization segment, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. All right, can't wait to see you. I'll see you there. Bye-bye.